Hello, Framingham High School. Welcome to New England Sports Minute. I'm Peter Tosti.
I'm Justin Markison.
And I'm Brad Tice.
For much of the postseason, the Red Sox have been relatively quiet, except for a couple of new signings here and there. However, the month of January seems to be their breakout month, showing interest in pitchers Edwin Jackson, Jair Jernings, and Roy Oswalt, all of whom would add depth to their rotation.
The Celtics only played two games this week, going 1-1, with a win against the dismal New Jersey Nets and a loss to the Pacers, in which they scored a franchise worst 25 points in one half. They're still at 500 with a 4-4 record overall. The Celtics are coming into a key part of their schedule with games against the Thunder, Mavericks, and Bulls. If the Celtics want to prove they're legitimate contenders, these are the proving games.
Since the last time we met, the Bruins went 2-1 in three games against New Jersey, Calgary, and Vancouver. Last Wednesday, the Bruins beat out New Jersey 6-1 and blew out Calgary 9-0 in a seemingly endless offensive attack. Unfortunately, the Bruins were stopped short by their Stanley Cup counterpart, Vancouver, 4-3. On an even sadder note, Bruins star player Brad Marchand was suspended by the league for a total of 5 games on a hit to Sammy Salo against Vancouver on Saturday. Coach Claude Julien is respectful of the decision by the league to suspend Marchand, but believes that the length of the suspension is outrageous. The Bruins are still first in the division and second in the conference behind the Rangers with a 26-11-1 record.
The New England Patriots are coming off their bye week and are preparing for their divisional round playoff game against the Denver Broncos. Denver Tebow the Steelers last week at Mile High in a terrific overtime victory.
First snap of the overtime. The Broncos have been in 3 overtime games this year. They won them all.
Got him
at the 40. It's Thomas at the 50. Stiffer got him free to the 30, to the 20. Thomas to the 10. Denver's going on the New England. They win it on the first play of overtime.
The Pats will face off against the Broncos Saturday night at 8 p.m. at Gillette Stadium, with recently hired returning Josh McDaniels as an offensive assistant.
Thanks for watching New England Sports Minute.
Have a great Wednesday, FHS.
I'm Brad Tice.
And I'm Justin Markison.
And I'm Peter Tosti. See you next time.